Thank you for joining me in the History of Science Collections of the University of Oklahoma Libraries. Let's look at a few books that throw light on the story of science in Asia. China Monumentis, printed in Europe in 1667 by Athanasius Kircher, contains two maps which reflect a growing European awareness of the history and significance of the people of Asia. On this map of Asia, we can see the subcontinent of India. Kircher's more detailed map of China may be the first map of China to be printed in Europe. Europeans were beginning to recognize that Chinese history was as ancient as Egypt's, and that Chinese cultural achievements were equal to their own. Confucius lived in the early 5th century BCE, roughly contemporary with the Pythagoreans and pre-Socratic natural philosophers. Confucius taught, "Do not do to others what you do not want done to yourself," an early version of the Golden Rule. Confucianism emphasized the cultivation of justice and sincerity in relationships, beginning with one's family, including respect for one's ancestors and tradition. This edition of Confucius, printed in Paris in 1687, contains another map of China published only 20 years after Kircher's. Yin and Yang, a recurring motif in traditional Chinese thought, expresses the idea of the interconnectedness of opposites. Phenomena which appear to us as dualities, such as darkness and light, or high and low tides, will turn out to be interdependent and profoundly related. This is the Yellow Emperor's Canon of Moxibustion, a classic treatise on acupuncture. It describes acupuncture treatments for a variety of conditions, with 36 depictions of acupuncture points for both adults and children. This copy was printed in 1659. This is a set of samurai manuscripts drawn on rice paper in the mid-1800s, copied from sources dating to the mid-16th century. We have the book about the arrow, the book about leggings, a book about the quiver, and a book about clothing. We can use this work to represent Asian astronomy. Here is an armillary sphere with feet of dragons. It was written by Baba Nobutaki, a Kyoto physician, and published in Osaka, Japan in 1706. Baba countered superstitious interpretations of solar eclipses and used magnetic theory rather than yin and yang to explain the tides. Baba adopted the Tychonic model of cosmology. So this work exemplifies the interplay between Asian and European ideas. In this book, in 1620, Francis Bacon championed the new era of modern discovery by pointing to three supreme novelties: printing, gunpowder, and the magnet. The richness of pre-modern Asian science is evident in the irony that each of these three modern European discoveries actually came to Europe from Asia, unbeknownst to Bacon. The starting point for modern Western understanding of traditional Chinese science is the monumental work of Joseph Needham. The massive volumes of Needham's Science and Civilization in China explore the scientific heritage of Asia. Similar works are appearing for other regions of Asia, such as this 12-volume History of Science in India. Asia boasts a rich history of science and technology, even before the scientific revolution of early modern Europe. Science is a story. What stories do you want to hear and tell about science in Asia?